heartening degree. And our special guest of honor, he deserves a deep gratitude from us. Professor Abhigam Sadhwani Kumar, he is the director of Aurelia Institute of Ayurveda in Delhi. And we are really glad to have him here. So I would like to first invite him on the stage so that Dr. Oleg Sorokin can give him a small memento of our appreciation. Dr. Sorokin, please. Thanks from the bottom of my heart to all of you who have come here, and I would like to thank especially those people who have come all the way from outside Delhi, from all across India. It's really a heartening feeling. And our special guest of honor, he deserves a deep gratitude from us. Professor Abhigam Sadhwani Kumar, he is the director of Aurelia Institute of Ayurveda in Delhi. And we are really glad to have him here. So I would like to first invite him on the stage so that Dr. Oleg Sorokin can give him a small memento of our appreciation. Dr. Sorokin, please. Can you please come and say a few words to our audience so that we can start our process?
Good morning to everyone.
I think those who are coming outside from Delhi, today it may be a very good or something very unique morning for you. You know that today we are here for a very specific cause. Everybody is aware and connected with some very unique ancient wisdom. And you are practicing that, whether you may be from the field of clinics or the wellness or therapist, anybody you may be. But anyhow, the basic thing in your practice is linked with the ancient wisdom. Ancient wisdom is derived by experience. So we are having the treasure of thousand and thousand years with us, with this knowledge. But you know, normally there is a saying, you do commit some mistakes when practicing a very specific technique of pulse analysis. It is based on our experience. So very similar to the computer, and recently we know the machine learning, artificial intelligence. So the computer learn by its own, by engaging database. So that is the human mind, and that practice used to be there the pulse diagnosis, because it requires a lot of experience and skill to come to any conclusion, to say something about a person, about his physiology, about the pathology. So to simplify it, all the things, all the information has been converted into a device. Now it is very easy for a beginner also to utilize the ancient power of knowledge in a very easy way. So I think Dr. Ollis, he deserves to say from my side, I will just like, because I am representing I'm in the community, so I just want to say thanks to provide such type of device to all of us. And definitely, when we go for any mechanization or any instrumentation, lot of things are there, and nothing is complete. You can recall any means. Few years ago, we were having this dialing phones, and the technology changed very fast, and now even every pocket is having. I can recall in my childhood period, even you have to book a call. It was not easy to have phone at every home, and you have to contact to exchange, and exchange people put leads from here to there to connect. But now every pocket is having a device to connect the world. So I think this is a very good beginning to have products. Definitely in future you will get more and more refined version, because I'm not very much aware about the deepest technology used, but if it is not, the product will tremendously increase its potential by putting the machine learning technique, because the more data is generated, more it is used, so the machine can learn by itself, and it can increase the efficacy of the product. I think if it is already there, so nothing to say. again. Dear friends, one more thing is that whatever you do, do with confidence. And for confidence, either you have to rely on yourself or you have to rely on others' skill, knowledge and experience. So that comes, means then this category is the teacher. Sometimes teachers, they provide face-to-face lecture. Sometimes they provide some very good notes. So it becomes very easy for the student to go forward. Again here, this device is just like your teacher's notes, so you can utilize with confidence, I think. And I have gone through this product, not here in India, but when I was in Germany, there was one European conference. I was having enough time to spend there and in this time. So I spent about 3 hours. One day and the second day also very good time to learn more about the system, and I was fully convinced with that, because several years before I started to use neurobiofeedback technique, means about 15 years before I was having device. So then I found out that of course there is a linkage with whether it may be the ARV or the whatever autonomic nervous system react with certain conditions according to our faculty. So linkage with several things can be made with this technique. And personally, because you know that when the product comes into market, it requires a lot of study, a lot of the experimentation, and very successfully. Yes, I know several people who are using this device, and they are very satisfied. And now it is time. Again, I would like to emphasize, now it is time not to waste your time, precious time. You just directly go with the devices which are available with you, and definitely by putting two things, means of course every device is having some limitation, so you go with device. Parallelly, you can go with your skill and put these two things together. So then I think you will be doing very well with your patients, with your clients. That is the procedure I used to adopt. Fully dependent on your skill sometimes, because again, everything is like a software. So by knowledge, by gaining knowledge, we used to improve our own software. And if you are not in contact with the technology, not contact with the updates, so your own software is very, very much old. So you are not comfortable to meet out the requirement of this fast changing world. So with these words, I congratulate Dr. Alvin and IBS Sutra team for coming, join hands together, I think, because I am aware of both of you very well for last several years. So it is a very good sign for all of us that you two are together, and definitely it will reflect in a very positive way in India and other part of world too. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Abhimanyu. So now I have one more
special guest to introduce before we begin the seminar. And Dr. Nitin Agarwal from Bliss Ayurveda, he's also here, and we would like to felicitate him as well. And please come and say a few words to the audience. Dr. Oleg Sorokin, can you please felicitate him? I'll just bring the...
Dr. Oleg Sorokin, Director for BioQuant, coming to guide us about Veda Pulse right from Novosibirsk, Russia. It's a pleasure. And all our esteemed guests who have come from Delhi and from other parts of India, you are welcome. I am Dr. Agarwal, of course, as Managing Director of Bliss Ayurveda, also an Ayurvedic doctor, I think that's more important. As well as for the patients to know what exactly they are getting. Yes, in India we have the privilege of having Ayurveda graduates who are very well versed in all the other aspects of Ayurveda, including pulse reading and Prakriti Pariksha. Dr. Abhimanyu himself is a very good expert in Prakriti Pariksha. But not everybody is trained so well in Prakriti Pariksha, in which you can know your body type, which means that you can know what is good for your health, to maintain your health. Vata type, Pitta type, Kapha style, what should be your like Ahar and Vihar, which means like, again, your whole activities during the day. And on top of it, what are the Ayurveda herbs that will be good for you? As we all know, Ayurveda herbs, if given in a holistic way, they are very effective. If they are pure, they are really working, very quick acting. It's a myth that Ayurveda is slow acting. It is not slow acting. Ayurvedic medicines work as equally fast as any other medicine. The only thing is what we expect from that. And our experience with the Ayurveda medicines is that even if you have problems, for example, constipation, you recommend an Ayurveda medicine, for example, Trifla or things like that. You take it during the night with warm water, and next day you have the results. So it's as quick with no side effects. A lot of people say that there might be a possibility of side effects. I disagree with them, not because I'm an Ayurveda, but because Ayurvedic formulations are designed in a way that they are itself holistic in nature. And all the actions, they are always, there are other herbs which are called secondary and tertiary herbs or bioavailable herbs present in a formulation, which are supportive to the main herbs, main action, as well as preventing any side effects coming from that particular action or action of the herb. So the overall approach is itself is holistic. And this experience, by this experience, we are able to prove to the Western world, especially to the doctors there who were a little bit skeptical in the beginning that whether we can use these Ayurveda medicines or the products to their patients without much deeper knowledge, because they don't have a degree for that, they don't have like a proper study for that. But with their own experience, they realized that yes, it's working, it is viable, and if combined with their own system of medicine, it has no known contraindications or interactions. And in that way, we were able to establish the good name of Ayurveda. Of course, I always put a note of caution that all the doctors, practitioners of Ayurveda, they should be very careful with the quality of the products, the quality of the treatment, and the quality of the knowledge. It is very important, because the problem is not in Ayurveda. The problem is in the knowledge that we get compromised for some reasons or for some financial reasons, and then here the bad name starts. So it will be my humble request to all the people who are in our audience, wants to practice Ayurveda and wants to practice through Veda Pulse, the diagnostic means and things like that, understand it properly and then very purest things, and demand from your whoever is the manufacturer, whoever is the doctor, that we need something qualitative and we should know about it. If we are using an Ayurvedic formulation, we should know what are the ingredients, we should know what is the quantity, and we should know what are the parameters of quality, especially when it comes to heavy metals, pesticides, microbiological contamination. If we are able to establish these means, very confident, we can give to all our patients, we can give it to pregnant women, we can give to children with a very, very safe heart. Otherwise, it's a very big guilt conscious that we live in. So that is, I think I will leave the seminar for the main speaker, Dr. Oleg. And the reason is that we have very successful experience, specifically in Russia, in Ukraine, and a few other countries like in Germany and Italy, where combining Ayurveda with technology, and Veda Pulse is a technology created to basically find out the prakriti of a person and to read the what we call the pulse reading or nadi parikshan, what we call in Ayurveda. And if we are combining these two things too and get a initial diagnosis from it, it will be very helpful for us to for a preventive as preventive health care and also as basic medicines. So I hope we will enjoy this session and you all will enjoy this session today. And so thank you very much.
Hi everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. And I suggest guys, if you could move up a little bit, it will be easier for you. So today we're all here to learn about this amazing technology that Dr. Oleg and his team have developed to improve the quality of our lives and of the community at large. Most of us here are from the field of wellness and alternative medicine, or are linked to it in some way or another. And we all understand the importance of early diagnosis. Yeah? So out of personal experience, I can vouch for the accuracy of this amazing diagnostic tool, and it's also helping me with specific to live a very, very healthy life. Firstly, I'd like to thank all of you that are here today and are part of the wellness industry, because I believe a big shift is happening in the industry. The problem with the old ways is that our medical industry was more about curing the sick and not about keeping well. And devices like Veda Pulse make it very empowering for us to kind of change our lifestyle and lead a very healthy physical physical and mental life ahead. So yeah, without any further ado, I'd like to call upon stage Dr. Oleg Sorokin, who is a PhD and a leading developer of Veda Pulse Technologies. He's also the executive director of the National Ayurvedic Medical Association of Russia. So welcome, if you could please take us through the presentation ahead.
And my colleague name is Andrew. He helped me to translate my presentation because my English is not enough to speak directly, sorry. Which is why today we start to learn Russian language.
Okay, so I'll do my best to translate. Pardon me for any mistake that I'll be probably making. I'm not perfect, but I'm just trying.
Итак, пока мы решаем технические вопросы, давайте я немножко расскажу о себе, и мы перейдем к презентации.
So, while we're solving some technical issues, I'm going to tell a few words about myself.
Потому что всегда задают вопрос, как западный ученый мог разработать систему бытовой диагностики, которая очень аутентична понятиям аюрведы.
Because there's always been one question that is asked to Dr. Oleg Sorokin. How come that a Western doctor could invent something which is in the field of Eastern knowledge, Eastern science?
Итак, я действительно получил классическое западное медицинское образование и защитил научную степень по двум дисциплинам – иммунология и физиология.
And that is true. I'm a Western doctor. I graduated from a medical university. I have a PhD degree in clinical immunology and electrophysiology.
Но мое сердце всегда принадлежало фитотерапии, которой я занимаюсь уже, наверное, больше 20-25 лет.
Heart lies in the field of clinical herbal therapy, which I'm doing for almost 20 years.
Итак, больше 20 лет назад я познакомился с аюрведой через нескольких людей, кто привезли ее в Россию и обучали врачей тому, что такое аюрведа.
More than 20 years ago, I discovered what Ayurveda is through a couple of
who are during this time are carrying knowledge around the world.
И тогда, как западный врач, я понял, что, к сожалению, скептический ум западного врача не позволит принять все на веру. Вот почему для западного специалиста необходим объективный метод оценки состояния человека.
And then, as a Western doctor, I understood that it's not possible for other Western doctors to understand the concepts of the Eastern medicine.
And I think that we need to find a solution for the Western doctors to understand what Ayurveda is.
И таким образом, на протяжении более чем 10 лет мы проводили серьезные углубленные исследования в различных институтах. В первую очередь в Новосибирском медицинском университете, где я работал как профессор кафедры физиологии и как декан лечебного факультета. И примерно лет 10 назад мы создали такую технологию, которую назвали VedaPulse, и сегодня я о ней вам расскажу.
And around 10 years ago we created a technology which is called VedaPulse today. And today I'm going to tell you about it.
Следующий слайд. Но перед этим всегда я настраиваюсь на связь со своими покровителями, и мы быстро прочтем молитву.
But before I start every lecture, I always show my gratitude to my mentors, so we'll start with it, we'll do a prayer.
Я думаю, вы прекрасно знаете эту молитву. Потому что это первая сутра Аштанги. И в западной традиции эквивалентом понятия Дхармантри является Пантелеймон Целитель.
who is the protector of all the herbal therapists and healers.
Поэтому попросим Харвантари и Пантелеймона Целителя сегодня нам помочь прочесть лекцию так, чтобы вы поняли, что такое ведокурс. Следующий слайд. Итак, технология, о которой я вам сегодня расскажу, это научная разработка целой группы ученых, которая работает в рамках Национальной аюрведической медицинской ассоциации России.
So the development that we are going to talk about today is a joint development of many scientists who are working within the National Ayurvedic Medical Association of Russia.
Ассоциация имеет продвижение аюрведы в России и консолидирует всех ученых и врачей, кто занимается популяризацией аюрведы в России.
This association does the promotion of Ayurveda in Russia and joins up all the Ayurvedic doctors in Russia.
В России нету аюрведы. Ее нету на государственном уровне в рамках юридической плоскости.
There's no Ayurveda in Russia. It's not there because of the legal limitations. It's not fully legalized there.
Следующий слайд. Но в 2014 году произошло очень знаменательное событие, где встретились два лидера наших стран, и впервые в истории Россия взяла на себя обязательство, подписав соглашение, развивать аюрведу в России.
But in December of 2014, two leaders of great countries joined up together to find out a plan for strengthening of Ayurveda in Russia.
И после этого, этой знаменательной встречи произошли тектонические сдвиги. Впервые Министерство здравоохранения создало комиссию, в состав которой я вхожу, с тем, чтобы выработать юридические основы для имплементации методов Ayurveda в здравоохранении.
And after that, there were some big shifts, tectonic shifts in the Russian medical system. And there was a commission created, which I am the head of, which started to find legal basis for Ayurveda in Russia.
Поэтому, когда я сегодня буду говорить о ведопульсе, мне бы хотелось и о том, как развивается Аюрведа в России, потому что ведопульс — это разработка российских ученых.
So while we will be talking about Ayurveda today, I would also like to tell you about Vedapulse today. I would also like to tell you about Ayurveda in Russia, because Vedapulse is a Russian development.
Следующий слайд. И наша ассоциация имеет несколько целей. Ассоциация — это выработка федеральных образовательных стандартов. Обучение врачей в области аюрведы.
So, our association has several goals, and one of them is development of national educational standards for Ayurveda.
На сегодняшний момент традиционная китайская медицина имеет официальное легальное поле в России, и существует врачебная специальность рефлексотерапевт, в рамках которой врач может легально использовать метод традиционной китайской медицины.
Today, traditional Chinese medicine is fully legalized in Russia, and we have a specialty for the doctors of traditional medicine, which is called a reflexologist. And these people who study reflexology, they can operate in Russia.
И чтобы по такому же пути прошла аюрведа, нам нужно решить несколько задач. И одна из главных задач — это разработка объективного метода, который устроит западного врача для оценки функционального состояния человека с позиции Аюрведа. Так и появился Ведапурус.
And this is the path that Ayurveda needs to go to Russia. And first of all, what we need to do is to find the objective means of diagnosis to support the decisions of Ayurvedic doctors. And that is why Ведапурус technology was created.
Поэтому федеральные образовательные стандарты должны содержать не только знания, которые мы, безусловно, должны подчеркнуть из контакта с различными ассоциациями, в том числе и индийскими ассоциациями, но и современные технологии.
So, federals need to find both the knowledge from the international context with fellow Ayurvedic association and from objective sources like Ведапурус.
Следующий слайд. И в этом отношении мы не одни. Нам активно помогают различные европейские ассоциации. Слушай, ну надо что-то сделать.
Может быть его поставить на профиль? Он чуть-чуть уменьшится, но это все
И задача, которую мы взяли перед собой, это найти юридические основы для развития Аюрведы в России. Это задача, в которой нам помогают различные европейские и другие ассоциации по всему миру.
And the task that we have at hand right now is to find the legal basis for Aюрведа in Russia or Aюрведа. We are cooperating with different associations of Ayurveda and in Europe as well.
И в первую очередь мне хотелось бы отметить такие имена, как доктор Рам Манохар из AVP Research Foundation, который является научным адвайзером нашей ассоциации.
And if speaking about India, it is first of all Manohar, who is the head of leading scientific organization of India in the field of Ayurveda, AVP Research Foundation.
И из европейских стран это доктор Антонио Маранди, который возглавляет итальянскую юридическую ассоциацию.
And speaking about Europe, it is Dr. Antonio Maranghi, who is the head of the Ayurvedic Association of Italy.
И, воспользовавшись моментом, мне бы очень хотелось пригласить к взаимодействию всех здесь сидящих специалистов, потому что наша ассоциация — это площадка, на которой мы обмениваемся знаниями, и многие специалисты со всего мира читают лекции и проводят образовательные курсы.
And I want to use this chance to invite all of you to join us up to be a part of this international organization for the promotion of Ayurveda, because many of the specialists are reading lectures on our educational platform.
И мы также проводим различные международные исследования, поэтому если здесь помимо врачей есть исследователи, мы также открыты к взаимодействию, в том числе с использованием Ведапурса.
And we are also conducting studies, so if there are any scientists here, apart from doctors, we would love to have you with us.
Итак, Ведапурус — это научная разработка Национальной юридической медицинской ассоциации. Это плод деятельности очень большого коллектива ученых. И сегодня мне хотелось бы рассказать, а какие алгоритмы, какие идеи заложены в работу Ведапурса.
So VetaPulse is the development of the National Ayurvedic Medical Association of Russia. It is the result of the work of many scientists. But today I would like to tell you in detail what algorithms are lying behind VetaPulse. What is the science behind VetaPulse?
И в первой части своей лекции я хотел бы ответить на три главных вопроса. Во-первых, какова связь между пальпацией пульса и пульсовой волной и очень уникальным феноменом, который называется вариабельность ритма сердца?
And in today's lecture, I would like to answer three main questions. The first question is, what is the connection between the pulse analysis, traditional pulse analysis, the pulse wave, and the phenomenon of the heart rate variability.
И второй вопрос главный. Если информация о пульсе органов, о состоянии различных органов и систем есть в пульсовой волне, значит она есть и в ритме сердца.
And the second question is, if there is an information about all of the organs, the state of the organs and functional systems in the pulse wave, then what is the connection of it to the...
Есть ли физиологическое объяснение тому факту, что в пульсе и в ритме сердца есть информация о дошах и функциональных системах?
Is there any physiological explanation of the fact that heart rate, rhythm, and pulse wave contain the information about dosha paths and state of the organs?
Ну и самый главный вопрос. Берем ответы на предыдущие два. То самый главный вопрос, как с помощью современных математических методов эту информацию о балансе дош можно извлечь из ритма сердца?
Two of the questions, and we will have the answer to the third one. How can we extract the information about doshas and information about the organ states from the heart rhythm using the modern mathematical methods?
Следующий слайд. Если говорить о пульсовой диагностике в Аюрведе, то она имеет противоречивую историю, и это является предметом моей диссертационной работы. Я глубоко изучаю пульсовой диагностики во всех традиционных системах мира.
Speaking about pulse analysis, it has a very controversial history. And that is actually my graduate study. It's the history of Nadi Vijnana, the history of pulse diagnosis.
И когда я получал наставление от доктора Васанклада, известного специалиста в области пульсовой диагностики, он рассказал мне историю о том, что существуют три основные школы пульсовой диагностики в Индии.
And when I was talking to my teacher, Dr. Vasanthlad, he told me that there are three main schools of pulse analysis used in India.
Первая школа – это так называемая популярная аюрведа, которой владеет более 90% Она связана лишь с поверхностным уровнем пальпации пульса.
First school is a so-called popular Ayurveda, which 90% of the specialists know, and it assesses only one level of the pulse.
И ее можно назвать популярной школой, потому что на самом деле глубоких познаний пульса она не дает. Но мое общение с индийскими врачами показало, что большинство врачей, к сожалению, владеют только
And we can call it popular art pulse analysis because by talking to different doctors in India, I discovered that 90% of them know only this type of the pulse diagnosis.
Вторая школа очень хорошо описана в учебниках для западных врачей доктора Атрея Смита, кто получил классическое аюрведическое образование и описывает три уровня пульсовой диагностики.
The second school is defined and described by Dr. Atreya Smith from Europe. He received classical Ayurvedic education and he describes three levels of the pulse.
Но мне хочется верить в то, что аюрведическая традиция долгое время сохраняла сакральные знания о пульсовой диагностике в виде устных традиций, потому что именно в аюрведе пульсовая диагностика, на мой взгляд, достигла наивысшей степени развития.
But I want to believe that this is the most classical, the most historical way of pulse diagnosis was transferred by oral communication, because I strongly believe that Ayurvedic pulse analysis is the best and the deepest pulse analysis that there is in the world.
И среди аюрведических врачей есть бытует мнение о том, что пульсовая диагностика длительное время передавалась в виде устных наставлений. И третья школа, которая касается семи уровней пульса, это сакральная школа пульсовой диагностики.
And there is a tradition according to which the knowledge was transferred by orally, and there is a sacral school of pulse diagnosis which assesses and describes seven levels of the pulse.
Ну и действительно, если вы возьмете классические каноны по аюрведе, допустим, аштанга, чарака, сушрута, самхита, вы не найдете там упоминания о пульсовой диагностике.
But it is true, if you will take canonic studies like аштанга, чарака, сушрута, you will never find the description of pulse diagnosis there.
Там есть лишь косвенные упоминания, которые могут намекать об этом виде диагностики, но первое подробное описание пульсовой диагностики в аюрведе появилось в письменных источниках в XIV веке благодаря знаменитому труду Шрамбадхара Самхиты.
And there are some indirect signs that there could be pulse diagnosis at that time, but the first obvious proofs of the existence